Welcome WVP stars. Today we're gonna make a venison Wellington. It's our signature main course. Everybody knows a Wellington, but here we use venison from New Zealand. We have foie gras from France, and we have rendang mushrooms. And I'm very happy that two of my team will assist me today, because fine dining is not a one-man show. It's a teamwork. So this is Anissa and this is Cindy. And they're gonna help us today to show you how to make the perfect Wellington. So we already prepared one. Later on we're gonna show you how to make it. And Anissa will put it in the oven and then we're gonna start to explain the whole dish.
So we're gonna put the Wellington in the oven. We put it off the tray, so it's gonna cook similar and crunch. Normally we put 12 minutes until it's ready.
So meanwhile, Anissa put the Wellington in the oven. We start with 12 minutes and then we're gonna check if it's good. Of course, every Indonesian dish, mostly when you make bumbu, you start with the spices. So the selection of the spices is black pepper. We have white pepper, we have coriander seed, we have cloves, we have cardamom, we have star anise, we have nutmeg, we have downsalam, we have limo leaf, turmeric leaf, galangal, ginger, cinnamon, lemongrass, garlic, shallots, and of course, chili. If you want to have it more spicy, you can add a little bit the small chilies, or you can add the chili with the seeds. So this all combined, we grind it again, we make a paste, we saute, and we add palm sugar, we add puja. It's palm sugar with coconut, roasted. And then you get this paste. Why are we using rendang for the venison Wellington? The most interesting for me is the cinnamon. Because back in Belgium, when I made the venison dish, I used the spiekeroos for the sauce, and the cinnamon is then one of the ingredients. So meanwhile, Cindy will sear the meat and the foie gras to make the roll. While she is doing this, I'm gonna show you how we make our sauce. So we take again a little bit of oil. The foie gras is seared very shortly. Meanwhile, for the sauce, we have always trimming from the venison because we use a nice piece, like you can see, we cut. But again, we use everything. So for the sauce, we start to sear the meat as well. Then we add some paste from the rendang, spices. I love it. I after everything is seared for the sauce, we add the stock. Now again, we're gonna infuse the stock with all the fungo and with the venison. We let it infuse on the side. Meanwhile, Anissa will make the roll for the Wellington. So we use chopped mushroom. We have also a little bit minced meat of the venison that we're going to use to protect the meat inside and the pastry. All the spices.
Foie gras in the middle. Like this. And we're gonna roll it all over the venison and the foie gras. Side to make the shape is perfect. Thank you.
Then after this, we're gonna roll with the filo pastry. We're gonna roll it with the puff pastry. gonna put the puff pastry with a layer. So we're gonna put the a layer of puff pastry on top of the venison wellington.
Mushroom. So we have the brown one and the white one. We use nasturtium to give a little spice kick, and the nasturtium is from our garden in the greenhouse. Many herbs we grow ourselves, some vegetables. So now we have our wellington, the venison, hopefully correctly cooked, and then we're gonna plate it together on the plate with the mashed potatoes and truffle, and then we're going to use our sauce that we made from the venison with the red and spices, and like you can see, still nice red, medium. And all the flavors of the red and are in the mushrooms. Then put the wellington in the middle. And then we add all the flavors of rendang. on the Wellington and the foie gras. And like I said, the idea came from the speaker rolls that I always combined in Belgium with the venison. So here we didn't have speaker rolls, so I had to be inventive. And then I checked the spices from the rendang, the cinnamon, and all the other spices, and the ginger. It's a perfect combination. So if you eat this all together, I can say it's one of the favorites of the restaurant so far. We're not so long busy, but everybody gets happy when you get this.